Welcome to the 2024 Assistance to Firefighters Grant Program Application Development Training Series. In this session, we will be discussing the application submission process. My name is Joseph Bauer, and I'm the Program Officer for the Chicago Region 5 Office. Before we get started, we want you to know that help is available to you throughout this process. One resource is a Regional Fire Program Specialist. There is at least one in each of the 10 FEMA regions. The URL here will take you to the website to view their contact information. The next option is the AFG Help Desk. It is staffed daily by fire service professionals that know the program and the fire service. The last bullet contains a link to our website where you can download self-help materials to assist you with developing your application and your narrative. We will discuss these later in the presentation. The program sends out monthly newsletter and program updates as necessary. Ensure you are signed up to receive these critical emails. All awards have been made for all the 2023 AFG programs. You should have received your turndown letter if you were not awarded. If you'd like more information on why you were not successful, there is a link in your turndown letter to request that additional assistance, or you can simply contact a regional fire program specialist. Depending on when you're viewing this webinar, the 2024 AFG application period is open or will be opening soon. The application period will open at 9 a.m. on the first day and end at 5 p.m. on the final day. All times are Eastern Time. Today's program is primarily comprised of an overview of the PPE and equipment activities. We will also cover what's new for 2024 and our top 10 best practices. The fire grant programs have three parts. The first, the Assistance to Firefighters grant, which is what we're discussing today. The second, Staffing for Adequate Fire and Emergency Response, better known as SAFER, which provides funding to fire departments to increase staffing to meet national standards, either through hiring full-time staff or the recruitment and retention of volunteers. And third, Fire Prevention and Safety, provides funding to bolster fire prevention activities within a municipality. It also has a research and development component to fund studies that could impact fire service and firefighter safety. Below each program is the funding that Congress has appropriated for fiscal year 2024. Initially, both AFG and SAFER are equally funded at $324 million. However, 10% of the funds allocated to AFG are used to fund the Fire Prevention and Safety Grant. Let's discuss what is new for 2024. Language was added to clarify ineligible items under the wellness and fitness activity. We discussed those in the wellness and fitness modifications to facilities and training session. For state fire training academies, language was added to clarify eligible costs with respect to the repairing of training props. Under the equipment activity, the other EMS equipment line item was replaced with several specific items that were then prioritized high, medium, or low. Please watch our equipment and PPE training session to learn more. To apply for the Assistance to Firefighters Grant Program, you must be registered and active in the System for Award Management. Your SAM.gov account becomes inactive after a year if no action has been taken to update the account. So make sure this is done prior to applying to ensure your account does not become inactive throughout the award process. Entity validation for new registrants can take anywhere from 5 days to several weeks, depending on the documentation needed for the validation. If you do not have a SAM.gov account, it is imperative that you get started on this immediately. The system is free and requires no cost to register. In addition, help getting registered is also free. On the slide is the web address for the Federal Support Desk and their phone number, depending on your preference. Let's discuss the application submission process. On the next few slides, we will discuss the application submission process. During the application process, there is a signature bar in the upper right-hand corner of your application that will tell you the status of your application. From the time that you start the application to the time that you submit for signature, you will see the pending submission status in the status bar. Once you submit for signature, you will see the pending AOR signature status in a status bar. Only after you have finished the application submission process, you will see the submitted to FEMA status. Once you have completely filled out your application, you will see all the application sections with a green check mark next to them. This will cause a Submit for Signature button to become active. At this point, if you're satisfied that the application is complete, you should click on the Submit for Signature button. In doing so, you are sending the application to the authorized organizational representative to complete the application submission process. Once you have clicked on the Submit for Signature button, this is what you'll see. If you are the authorized organization representative, you can click on the Submit Application link at the bottom left side menu. If you are not the authorized organization representative, it will be important to let the person know that this is what they'll need to click to start the application submission process. Once the authorized organization representative clicks on the Submit Application link, the application will require them to sign off on a few certifications and assurances before they can sign and submit the application. Here's an example of one of those certifications. It pertains to lobbying. In this case, they'll simply click on the radio button, enter their password, and click sign. The list below are certifications and assurances that the authorized organization representative will be signing prior to submitting the application. The first is a certification that, if awarded, your organization will comply with the terms and conditions of the award. The next certification has to do with lobbying activities, and a certification that disclosure of lobbying activities is not necessary. The third certification has to do with reading and understanding a notice of funding opportunity. The next certification is regarding the accuracy of the information provided in the application. The fifth certifies that the person signing is authorized to submit the application, and the final two certifications are confirming the primary contact and the final signature to submit the application. Once you have completed the certifications and assurances, the Submit button will turn blue as you see here. There's also an option to return to edit the application. If you choose to return to edit the application, you will have to repeat the application submission process. Once you click on the Submit button, you will receive a notice that the application has been submitted in green, like what you see above, where it says Signature Accepted. The status bar in the upper right-hand corner will say Submitted to FEMA. Once you have submitted the application, there is an option to reopen the application if you need to make necessary edits. To do so, go to your grants page and to the application that has been submitted and click on the Select an Action drop-down menu, and there will be an option to reopen the application. Once you click on this link, you will see the Reopen Application Courtesy Notice pop up to ensure that you understand that you are about to reopen the application. You will have to resubmit the application prior to the application due date time. To complete this process, click the Yes button and the application will reopen. Some of what you'll want to consider for the purposes of planning and preparation is the application checklist that provides you with the information you'll need to compile to complete a large majority of the application. Next are self-evaluation sheets. There are two of these, one for regular operations and safety requests, a second for a vehicle acquisition request. The self-evaluation sheets provide you with the criteria that the panelist who will be reviewing your narrative is based on. We recommend providing anyone that is going to review your narrative with a copy of the self-evaluation sheets so that they can review it based on the same criteria and provide you with feedback as to whether you touched on all the items necessary. Our latest resource is the Narrative Development Toolkit. This document builds off the criteria outlined in the self-evaluation sheets and provides you with tips on how to meet that criteria. There are sample narratives included to help you get a feel for how your narrative should flow. In addition to printed documents, technical assistance is also available through the Help Desk and the Regional Fire Program Specialist. Here are the top 10 best practices. Start preparing now and read the Notice of Funding Opportunity. Use the application checklist and any other resources available to gather as much information as possible in advance of the application opening. Conduct your risk assessment and then align your request with the highest priorities of the program. Make sure when developing your narrative to tell your department's story and the unique reasons for your request. Stay away from vendor narratives, templates, or copying other departments' narratives. Read each question carefully, then answer it carefully. If you are not sure what a question is asking, reach out to your regional fire program specialist. Ensure that someone reviews your entire application to include the narrative before submitting the application. Be sure that your authorized organization representative has submitted your application. Make sure to account for all eligible costs that you can associate with your request. These include training costs, service agreements, extended warranties, and possibly performance bonds in the case of vehicle acquisition. Ensure that your project can be completed within the grant's 2-year period of performance and articulate that in the narrative. Check that you have the support from your community's decision-making authority and that they understand that there is a cost match required with this grant. Print your application using Command or Control P before submitting. And finally, a reminder to reach out if you need anything throughout the application period. Thank you for taking the time to view this session and for your interest in the 2024 Assistance to Firefighters grant.